Joyce, please meet Mike Aparo. He's starting to be a priest. Joyce here is one of our best administrators.
Oh, thank you. It's nice to meet you.
Glad to be here.
How long have you wanted to be a priest?
All my life.
Oh, well, then it's meant to be.
God willing. So.
Really? Father Farley has been a great mentor in guiding me in through that process.
He's such a nice guy. I would imagine that he would be.
They met, there's some sparks, and they fell in love.
I think I'm in love with you.
With me?
Yes. I think about it all the time. I'm going crazy. I guess I'm not going into the priesthood.
No?
A few years later, Joyce has big news.
I'm pregnant.
What do you do, Mr. Aparo? Call me Mike. I work for a Catholic Charities organization.
How did you hear about Joyce?
Mary from Joyce's office called. We're still on good terms.
But you weren't on good terms with Joyce.
We were married for 10 years, and it was a living hell. And I say that as a man of deep faith.
In fact, Mike's faith actually became one of the couple's many points of conflict.
She would torment Michael for his strong and fervent belief.
Where's Karen?
It's Sunday. She's at Bible study.
Oh, and why aren't you genuflecting?
She forgot her essay.
Her essay on what?
Well, that's between her and Father Farley.
Oh, you mean between her and her brainwasher.
Look, I know where you stand, but our daughter needs some spiritual guidance.
What she needs is a father who's not a Bible-toting simpleton and who pulls his weight around here financially instead of hiding under Father Farley's skirt like a coward. Oh, I wish you joined the priesthood.
It got to the point where you had two people basically that couldn't stand each other.
I did plan to join the priesthood, but I got involved with Joyce and saw a different path for a while.
But the Catholic Church frowns upon divorce, don't they?
It was the hardest decision of my life. When Joyce sent those papers over to be signed, well, I did it. I did it for Karen. I didn't want her to grow up and be surrounded by two miserable people constantly at each other's throats.
Joyce did what she could to discourage Karen from having a lot of contact with her father.
Last Wednesday night, where were you?
Here, all night.
Can anyone verify that?
My wife is out of town visiting relatives in Florida. I was here alone.
So the detectives walk away with a slightly different view of Joyce.
Well, I'll tell you, my antenna went off up there. We got a wannabe priest banished from his home, cut off from his only daughter by his cruel ex-wife.
Certainly a strong motive. Maybe he needs to go to confession.
Yeah, and confess to a murder.
How much abuse can a person endure before striking back? Even a righteous man can be pushed too far.
Music concert here tonight?
That was last night.
Oh, my gosh.
What the hell do you want?
The concert. You said it was tonight.
No, I didn't. I told you it was last night, and you missed it, like the pathetic father you are.
You are such a liar. Where's Karen?
When he realizes he's being played by Joyce, he tries to salvage it.
Karen!
She's not here. She's at Mr. Markov's, a real father.
God help you.
Note. I'm just gonna rip it up.
Every man has his breaking point.
As a matter of fact, I'm gonna erase all of her memories of you, of her growing up, of you going to church, of you praying together.
And for the first time in his life, he bites back.
Missing her concerts, missing her graduation, missing her getting married, missing, missing, missing!